want to welcome you into Guam Football Association and welcome back from the holiday hiatus for the Budweiser Soccer League 2017 portion of the 2016-2017 Budweiser Men's D1 action. Brought to you by Taco Bell, Live Moss, 76 Circle K, it's Red Dragon Sports, alongside Guam Football Association. My name is Blake Watson, joined alongside Shippy in the booth up here. And should be a great game as the two top teams in the league in Guam Shipyard and the Napa Rovers FC are meeting for the second time. First time resulted in a Guam Shipyard victory. Guam Shipyard getting the better of them in the last couple times as they also took the Bank of Guam Cup back in May when they met for the last championship.
But I think Rovers is going to come out fired up because of those last two losses, though. I think they're going to be ready for it. It all depends on what they did over the break, I think.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll see if the about a month-long break. As everybody's coming back from the Christmas holidays and the new year. And the last time these two teams met, as we mentioned, Shipyard came out victorious, and they have yet to lose a game this season. Napa Rovers looking to break that streak. David Drew's in goal for the Napa Rovers, and should be the young
Sean Evans
for Guam Shipyard, although Sean not wearing his traditional pink jersey.
Oh, you're right. But almost looks different that
right,
way.
Yeah.
These are two of the better keepers, though, on the island. So it should be a good defensive match right now.
Referees all set to go as linemen running to the side. And some of these games are known for the referees allowing some loose play and just allowing the players to really just do that and play. And we'll see how this crew calls the game tonight.
It all depends on what the referee decides. Some of them let it go and some of them don't.
Right.
They just got to adjust to it.
So just getting underway here on a nice and breezy night here in Harmon, Guam. GFA's National Training Center. First kick is underway, and now the Guam Shipyard squad will work it around. Nice shove from behind. We were wondering about the call of the ref, and
it's gonna call it early. It looks like.
Free kick will go to the blue and white. Shipyard now working it around. Swarmed by yellow jerseys.
I'm kind of surprised that Shipyard's going for that long ball early. They're usually more of a build it up and attack kind of a way instead of the run and gun.
A corner kick for Shipyard as they'll try to swing it in and strike here and early off the foot of Karosis. Karosis swings it in and it's intercepted in the box by the Rovers. They'll send it back out to midfield, and now Shipyard, they'll try to regain possession. Do Karosis kicks it away. As Cunliffe crosses it over to the box, and now the Napa Rovers will try the other side as they work the ball up to midfield now, finding holes in the midfield.
This is the way that Rovers like to play, just nice and slow, composed, and then to get that long ball there and try to beat them on that speed. Good clear by Camden.
In Mariano. Didn't really have a chance on us. It was kicked just a little bit beyond his reach, and now Romero, two on one. crossed in from the Rovers and headed out by Guam Shipyard as Rovers will reset and try it again. Jonah Romero kicking it back to FJ. FJ losing possession to Karosic, and now Karosic to Minchoy. Minchoy with some nice footwork, and he's got the through pass to Karosic. Karosic's on a two-on-one, and Jason Cunliffe there to defuse the situation, and David Drews will reset his defense.
It's a little dangerous of Drews to do that on that back line like that, but Jason was able to take care of that.
Yeah, interesting that he didn't just scoop it and clear it away.
Jason's playing deep this time, though, and playing in the defense instead of in the center mid.
Rovers look to be at full strength tonight as everybody is accounted for and playing. Cleared away by the Shipyard defense, and now the Rovers. They'll try to work it up to midfield. Jason Cunliffe clears it away. It's Lorenzo.
It's a good fight
there. And
then
Ian Mariano shoved off the ball by Min Choi.
Nice composure Rovers is having right there. Just gonna keep shifting it back and forth, it looks like.
FJ now, he'll work it up the side. Looking for some space now and clears it up. And Jonah Romero was just smothered by Ken Karosic as Ian Mariano.
Good build up. Oh, FJ mishit that. Well, it's a good switch. Oh, a little too hard though. The idea was there. Andre was a little sucked in. If he was pushed himself out a little bit more, that'd have been a great ball.
Rovers now, still working on the back line as they send it back across. FJ, he'll work it across the middle. It'll be scooped up by Ajay as he tries to clear it away, but Jason Cunliffe there to plug the hole. Keep it in front of him, and now he clears it well past midfield, and the Rovers letting it fall out of bounds. Working it around.
Oh, he's
that'll be Kim. It's
nice shot.
Tim and Kim firing it well over David Drews, but just over the crossbars.
He had a lot of yellow in front of him, too. Not much he could have done. It's a good look, though.
Yard now with the long attempt, and David Drews will smother it. Send it out to the captain. And FJ sends it over to Romero, back to FJ. FJ up to Dillenberger.
It's good defense by Shipyard right there. There's no harm done in kicking the ball out there.
Rovers working the ball around. The long ball from Jason Cunliffe up to Ian Mariano. Mariano gets tripped up. Referee lets it go, and it was Cleary who got underneath Ian. Ian takes a spill. Ball out of bounds on Shipyard, and Dillenberger.
Might have got lucky on that one, though.
Line up for the kick. Kicks it off the back of Cleary. Out of bounds.
Corner for Rovers. It looks like Ian's going to take it. Jason's going to come up from that defense up there.
And really, this is the closest that the Rovers have been to the Shipyard goal. This is the young Sean Evans, the Harvest Eagle senior, in front of the net. Plenty in the box now for Mariano as he swings it in.
A deep ball.
Off the head of the Rovers there in the middle, and now Dillenberger with the shot from goal,
nice
or from
shot.
Way back, and he makes it. He'll be counted for that one in the ninth minute.
It was a good setup the whole way through, though. Ball was a little deep from Ian, headed it back, placed it back to him, and took that shot off the foot. It's good. It's hard for Evans to see that kind of a ball, that many people in front of the goal.
Take a look at it again as Mariano will line up. And he'll try to get as much as he can, as he had plenty of people right in front of the net. Sends it in. There's the header. And then the pass to Jason Cunliffe.
Yeah.
And just a good heads-up play there from number 10. Rovers possession. Excellent throw in, a long one. FJ back to Jason Cunliffe. Cunliffe clears it across the field, and that'll roll out of bounds as his man not in position.
Mark Chargaloff going for something deep, but there's no one there. Dave Drews just takes that right away. Dave Drews is, it's funny we talked about Sean Evans. Dave Drews is probably the oldest guy in D1, 40 plus. I'm not too sure how many other guys are over 40, that's for sure. Oh, and a goal by Rovers.
Rovers getting an excellent opportunity, not sure who that was. As we will find, it's Marcus Lopez.
Marcus Lopez.
Number four.
Did he play for another team? And did he make the switch over during the transfer window?
I'm not sure about that.
I think he played for, I was thinking he played for somebody else in the beginning of the season, but I could be wrong. But that transfer window, that's when guys take that opportunity to switch things.
That's right. And you can see just an excellent strike there from Lopez. It's Marcus Lopez. Pulled back on that one and fired it right past Sean Evans. Excellent goal. 2-0. Napa Rovers, Guam Shipyard. Welcome back from the holiday hiatus if you're joining us on the live stream. Thank you for
that. Oh, that's a good...
GuamFA.com. Budweiser Soccer League Men's Division One action.
Here, Jason a little upset over there letting that ball get through.
Guam's Premier League is...
Nice one touch by Mark Chargalov there.
He keeps it, moves it up, and Chargalov just loses possession right back to the Rovers.
I think he thought Min was taking that run, but Min didn't go. First game back, they got to get back in rhythm again, maybe.
Just about 10 minutes or so left here in the first half, if there's no added time. Coming up on the 34th minute, Rovers. 2-0 over Guam Shipyard. Logan Dillenberger, Marcus Lopez finding the back of the net. Dillenberger off a little bit of a corner
cross
kick.
There.
And a nice
wow.
cross there and an even better bicycle kick.
Ashton.
As Ashton Server gets the crowd on their feet.
He's going to get a card for this, though.
And
looks
proposing?
Like he's proposing.
Is he proposing?
I guess so.
Is he?
If she says yes, it's worth it.
Ashton.
Oh, that was funny.
Just speechless a little bit there as Ashton Server scoring a goal, the third one of the match, and then running right over to the stands and proposing to his girlfriend.
I'm not sure if we got an answer out of that, though.
I'm not sure if we did or not. That's a little bit why I'm speechless on that. I'm not sure if he got the answer he wanted or if he got one at all. Take a look at that again.
Beautiful cross and just
Ashton Server.
Marking wasn't tight, but beautiful, beautiful bicycle by Ashton. Gotta tell you, I've never seen anything like that in Guam Soccer League.
It's a first for me, and got it all on video. Shipyard trying
in.
To mimic the same thing, but had nobody in the box there. And
oh,
header
so
opportunity
close.
There, but not close enough as it rolls right out of bounds. Shipyard.
That's the closest opportunity they've had, the best opportunity.
With their
had
best
so far.
Opportunity that they've had, just letting it roll right out of bounds.
They really needed that, too, to go back into halftime, one goal closer. Rovers really just now 3 goals up. They're really going to even slow it down a little bit more. Or
FJ
maybe they'll
now.
Just try.
Clearing it over to Cam Uggen. Just Cam Uggen plays for the Shipyard squad. Is now the Shipyard team. Wolverines, Shipyard, you know, it's a... it always trips me up to... You know, you want to call a team by their mascot. I'm not so sure if the Wolverines, I know the youth Wolverines, are, you know, that's their mascot name. We'll just roll with Guam Shipyard Wolverines, I guess. Could be at all levels, right? And then their former D2 team, known as Big Blue.
Right.
Which is, of course, the crane out at Guam Shipyard.
Yeah.
And now they are known as Hadza United.
Hadza United.
As they moved up to Division One. Guam Shipyard, undefeated nonetheless of what you call them. You can call them the best team by record now. As they've got their work cut out for them here early against the Napa Rovers, 3-0 with that unbeaten streak on the line.
I would have thought that Shipyard would have came out just a little bit more organized, maybe a little more fired up too.
do needing a little sense of urgency here on offense, and we'll see if they get it here. That's Mark Chargaloff.
Not to Andre Gaudia.
And Gaudia now will work one on the outside.
Lost it, though. Oh, it's a Shipyard throw-in to Mark.
Chargaloff, 10 on 10, as Jason Cunliffe smothers him.
It's always a good battle watching those two go at it.
Very familiar with each other. Teammates on the Metal.
Yes.
Guam men's national team, of course. And a few members of the Metal out there. You see number 3, Jonah Romero. Ian Mariano, also a Metal member.
Marcus Lopez as well.
Marcus Lopez. And we mentioned earlier, of course, Sean Evans.
And plenty of former national players out there. Cam Uggan, Ajay. You really hear Jason, though. He's commanding that team, telling them what to do.
Still lighting that fire. Is not comfortable with the 3-0 lead, not against
no.
This team. Is you know that they can score 3 really quickly, especially off the foot of Min Choi, if he can ever find some space and get himself going. Golden Boot Race winner from last year and Golden Boot Race leader from this season. No surprise. And FJ intercepting that one, Min Choi. Just frustrated a little bit. And
oh, Dave, that was a bad throw he had, but Rovers recovered pretty well.
For Lopez, and now the Rovers. Jonah Romero will work it around. It's at midfield. Lopez sending it back into the defensive line as they push things up. Now Ashton Serber using his speed to try to find some space, but Shipyard just all over that one, and now it's a 2-on-1, and Rovers just fighting for possession.
Another
Ian
shot.
Mariano with the shot on goal. Sean Evans,
good save.
Excellent diving save there for the rebound. The Rovers were trying for it, but Shipyard and the defense doing well to push it out of bounds.
That was a good hustle out there, too, to get that out of bounds. He had a couple Rovers guys coming at it, and Sean was still trying to get back up, so definitely a good defensive clear.
It's a low corner kick. I know wish he had that one back,
because yeah,
it wasn't,
sure.
Wasn't the greatest, and now Rovers, though, still able to maintain possession. Ashton Serber trying for the back heel pass for Jonah Romero, and Serber shoved from behind by Ken Karosic, and nice sportsmanship there at the end, just an initial contact.
Ken Speed might have got a little bit too much of him on that one. Or maybe he just intentionally meant to push him. You never know. Sometimes things happen so fast, you don't know what's going on.
It looked like he was...
It's a good ball by Jason.
He was falling, and Ashton Serber just happened to get in his way and take the fall for him. Cutler with the exact same shot, and...
It's a nice save by Sean coming
Sean
out
Evans
like that.
Absorbing the ball and the blow from his defenders. He ran into the body of Jason Landstrom there.
You could hear that collision up here, too.
Ken Karosic now loses possession.
Oh.
Mariano, and now Marcus Lopez being chased from behind by Shipyard. 2-on-1, and he's sandwiched.
That was Cam Uggan coming back. He missed that first touch, and he came to fight for that ball again.
Marcus Lopez expressing his disgust with the non-call, being called back on the ball by Jason Cunliffe, who says, keep playing, and now the Rovers do just that, as they're really working the ball around midfield and just having their way with
what
Shipyard
is back and forth.
Rolled out there, and now Sean Evans did well to get in front of Ashton Serber, who Almost got around him and put the ball in.
Landstrom headed it back, but Sean was coming up for it. Almost a miscommunication there.
A couple minutes left here in the half. No doubt some added time by the referee for the marriage proposal.
Yeah. Sure glad I was here for that one. Maybe we can find out if there's an answer.
Maybe we can. That's a definitely a first. Budweiser Soccer League Premier Division One action. Guam Shipyard in a 3-0 hole against the Napa Rovers. Two top-ranked teams in the league right now. Marcus Lopez for the Rovers now.
Taking it straight to the goal.
Right by Cleary.
Huggin
in a fight, and Ken Karosich comes out with it. Now he sends it around Romero, and the Rovers will send it right out of bounds. Regulation winding down. Under a minute. Throw in will go for the white and blue.
Defensively right now, Rovers doesn't want to give up anything. Just want to make sure they play smart. It's under a minute left. Give nothing up.
Gaudia, all alone up there.
But offensively, Rovers is okay getting another one if they can. Oh, nice touch by Serber.
And Serber, with the speed, crosses it to the middle of the box. It's intercepted, not long enough. And that'll be Jonathan Cleary, who sends it up to Ajay. Ajay loses possession to Jonah Romero. And Marcus Lopez there to try and get it back for the Rovers. Now Ken Karosich, nice move around Lopez with the cross, but just behind Gaudia. Halftime.
It's an interesting score. I didn't think I'd see this one.
Napa Rovers lead it 3-0. Guam Shipyard, Budweiser Soccer League Division One, Red Dragon Sports, Guam Football Association. Back from the holiday break as Taco Bell, Live Moss, and 76 Circle K bring you the action, and we'll be back with second half. More to come between Guam Shipyard and Napa Rovers as Shipyard tries to stay undefeated, but trail 3-0. Back after this. Second half action now as we want to welcome you back to it. Guam Football Association, Red Dragon Sports, Budweiser Soccer League, Men's Premier League, Division One action. Napa Rovers, Guam Shipyard playing, brought to you by Taco Bell, Taco Bell Live Moss, and 76 Circle K. Blake Watson up in the booth alongside Shippy this evening. And it's been an interesting first half, is kind of unexpectedly.
Very unexpected.
The Napa Rovers came out ahead after three goals and one early from Logan Dillenberger, and that kind of got it going.
Another great strike by Marcus Lopez a few minutes later. And that beautiful bicycle kick by Ashton. Of course, followed by his proposal.
The proposal. A first here. Definitely on this broadcast out here at GFA.
She did say yes, so the yellow card was worth it.
And an excellent goal it was. If you're going to propose, you definitely want it to be off a excellent bicycle kick.
Yes.
Like that one was. But Shipyard, with quite the hill to climb and capable of doing it, but the offense just playing with not much urgency. And
they just seem off compared to the other games that they've played before, the other ones that I've seen. They're disconnected, and they're just in general, there's not that urgency and intensity.
moving a bit sluggish, a little bit groggy out there, as they've just been outrun by the Rovers, who are looking a lot faster and a lot more precise than Shipyard this evening.
Men. Oh, he was looking for Mark on that run.
Chargilov. Coming up, stretching his left calf. After he really had to kick it into high gear there just to...
He was going, too.
Get around the defender.
That's the time when you look at him and, man, you should have got him that ball. When they're going that hard and that fast.
Min Choi being shadowed by FJ. Choi sends it to the middle. Chargilov.
Just
sends it back to the middle. Nobody there. And now the Rovers. We'll look for an opportunity. The ball is sent out of bounds. Ashton Serber. He'll take the throw in over to Mariano. Mariano lining up his kick, passing it over. And the Rovers just really able to settle things down, really able to complete their passes to where they need to be. And if all else fails, just send it back to Jason Cunliffe and let him reset the offense for you.
He'll take care of it. They're doing a great job of that, though. When they're in trouble, they just drop it back. And because Shipyard's not having anybody up there pressuring him, he's got that time to control things and let the rest of the Rovers regroup. Now, Shipyard made a change, though. Ken's on the side again. Usually he'd stay on the right side, but they moved him over to the left side this time.
Second half action. Budweiser Soccer League Division 1 just underway.
It's a good challenge, good fight there.
Napa Rovers still playing with the same intensity as they were in the first half, picking up right where they left off.
He also looks like Shipyard put in Chris Santos, Debo. He's up there.
Santos coming in as a pair of fresh legs for Shipyard. Looking to get all the help they can get now. Oh, another shot on goal from close range. And Ashton Serber, just in the right place at the right times. It comes right down on his foot, and he puts it right past Sean Evans. Second goal of the match for Ashton Serber.
Shipyard's in real trouble now. Down 4. They're only 5 minutes into that second half.
Keep it in bounds. Keep possession of it and just let the time just tick, tick, tick off as they've got the lead now. They can build on it and, more importantly, protect it.
And just take their time. They don't need to pressure anything. They don't need to go fast.
Kim now lines up for the shot. A hard one it is on
nice
goal
shot.
And right
wow.
in the back corner of the net.
Pretty.
And that could be the catalyst there for Guam Shipyard, who needed something desperately on offense. And Kim with an excellent top corner strike right past David Drews, who
nothing he was doing about
tried
that.
To dive and get it, but yeah, you're right. Just couldn't do anything but watch it go in.
I'm surprised Rovers gave him that much space to let him do it. Maybe they didn't think he was going to shoot it. Let's see if that fires up Shipyard a little bit, pushes him.
There it again is.
Right over Drews.
Well, out there at 40.
40 plus.
40 plus, yeah. And a hard, hard online shot there from Taman Kim. And that gives his team their first goal of the game, coming in about the 55th minute.
That definitely helps them a lot. Might be able to change momentum a little bit. Another corner kick.
Rovers swing it in, and plenty of people in the box.
Nice.
Sean Evans comes out with a hand and is able to knock the ball away.
Oh, looks like the referee's calling a goal kick, but Sean Evans definitely saved that. He's even saying he saved it. I don't see that very often. That was a good save by Sean Evans on that one, though. That's one of those just reaction saves and hope you get it kind of things. So it is another Rovers corner.
Four to one. Shipyard now with a little bit of life left. Finding the back of the net was Taman Kim, and we'll see if that can't spark the offense. Rovers, though, not letting up. Almost getting a shot there, as you saw, right in front of Sean Evans, but Evans with an excellent save, and now the throw-in will be from Jason Cunliffe.
Just slowing things down. Jason called off Marcus just so he can go over and throw it in. Another 10 seconds, Shaquille. The team like Shipyard, 10 seconds could mean another goal.
They can score fast and they can score a lot. They still got Min Choi. And speaking of, number
there
seven streaking through the offense now. And we'll see if Choi can get an opportunity.
It's a good shot.
Hard strike on goal, but David Drew's there to put a hand on it and get it out of bounds. Finally heard some Shipyard fans there with that one, as some momentum may be swinging, but Napa Rovers going to try their hardest to make sure that doesn't happen.
And if you're Guam Shipyard, you're definitely hoping it does. They need it right now. Chargaloff with a kick. It's in the mix.
Ajay putting his head on it, but well, out of bounds.
Even there, though, it looked like Shipyard doesn't have enough guys in the box compared to Rovers. Looks like they're not pressuring that kind of a kick. You just think Shipyard, after that goal, might feel a little more fired up and put something else in there.
With the latest goal, however, off Taman Kim, a long, hard strike from well over 40 meters out. Came in the 55th minute, but since then, the Napa Rovers have put a couple shots on goal themselves and are threatening again. It is now Ashton Server, maybe looking for another marriage proposal kick.
She already said yes once. I don't know how many more times she's going to say it.
Again, the marriage proposal from the first half. The kick is up and in. Ashton Server there with the bicycle finish. Scanning the crowd.
Trying to find her.
Looking for her. Had it under his shirt, and then marry me. No real audio reaction we didn't hear from any. But we got reports what she said yes, right?
She did say yes.
Okay. Sent you down to report on it during halftime, and she said yes, so it was worth it. And an excellent goal to make. I mean, if that's, you know, if that's the goal you want when you're going to do a marriage proposal on the field during the game as a player.
You couldn't draw it up any better, really.
No.
Yeah, he ran over at halftime because I'm not sure that she said yes to him when he was out there. She said yes when he got over there at halftime and then hugged her, kissed her, and then
ran right back out on the field.
Hugged his mom first and then ran back on the field.
Chris Santos there. Getting a little rough and showing some sportsmanship as he shakes hand there with the Napa Rovers. And
Debo's a big guy, though. He's going to knock some people over accidentally every now and again. I've been hit by him a couple times. I think it's interesting, though, that they have Debo up top instead of playing somewhere more of a defensive spot.
Napa Rovers now just playing keep away, taking their time, making sure that their passes are there. Flores now working it back. He'll send it to Ian Mariano. Mariano over to Ashton Serber. Ashton Serber trying to poke it through the defenders and find his man, but
it's good clearance there by Camden. Just follow
Shipyard
that ball
there
through
to defuse the situation. The ball rolls out of bounds.
That's something that Shipyard doesn't have when they're on the attacking side. Rovers had four guys up there, but Shipyard only has one or two when they're attacking.
Still hear the pass it chant coming from Jason Cunliffe. They're just trying to settle things down and kind of be methodical now with their ball movement. Is, you know, you got to think they just want to complete their passes and keep it away from Guam Shipyard. Keep it out of range of Min Choi and some
Mark
of these other
Chargaloff.
Mark Chargaloff, some of these other high, these other prolific goal scorers.
And they know now Kim can shoot, so.
Trail 4-1 with their unbeaten streak on the line. Top-ranked team in the league, Budweiser Soccer, Division One. Guam Football Association, along with Red Dragon Sports, Taco Bell, Taco Bell Live Mas, and 76 Circle K, welcoming you back from the holiday break.
Oh,
welcoming you to the 2017 portion of the season, the second half. Guam Shipyard, Napa Rovers, good game to kick us back off for the new year.
Second half really picked up.
And these two, again, no strangers to each other. And as you can see there in the distance, it's the Bank of Guam Strikers who are warming up for the second game. And they'll be taking on Quality Distributors. Both of those teams desperately needing wins.
Yes. It's a good save by Dave, just swatting it out. Cam Uggan, that ball right now to Mark Chargaloff.
Chargaloff back to Kim. Kim over to Pangalina, and Pangalina now will kick it over to Kim Karosic. And Karosic,
it's a little too far.
Tries to chip it up and over the defense, but they were smothered by FJ, their last line of Napa Rovers defense, and David Drews was in the goal ready to come out.
I think what Ken wanted to do on that was just lob it right over that defense and let Mark Chargaloff fight for it, but got too much muscle on it. Sometimes you got great ideas, you just can't capitalize on them. It's a good pass by Tevin, but Ken Karoshi just missed it.
Jonah Romero now, he's working the ball to the outside, sends it across into the middle. Ashton Serber looking over to the line, wondering if that wasn't a handball there on the Shipyard defense.
Yeah, he's either looking for a handball or a pass back, but that wasn't intentional. At least passing it back was definitely not intentional. Rovers is still smothering that defense.
And there comes Devin Mendiola.
Shipyard just doesn't have much to play with there.
Ken Karosic now. Karosic.
He just needs to keep it on the outside. You can beat him out there.
Karosic sends it to the middle, right off the chest of Jay Cunliffe. And Jason sends it back up and into traffic.
Rovers are just trying to keep that possession, but Shipyard's fighting for that stuff. They want everything right now. Tony Babauta going after it. Jonah with the ball again.
Jonah moving it through the midfield.
Looking for Ashton, but Tevin was there.
Did well to work it around Landstrom. Landstrom played all the minutes of this game. And fatigue starting to set in now. This is the final minutes of the game are coming up. Within 10 minutes.
Yeah, that first game from the break's always a little more fatiguing than the rest of them. Mm-hmm. You haven't been playing. You might be working out, but not as intensely as a game.
Still trying to keep yourself in shape. But yeah, like you said, you know, everybody wants to enjoy the holidays and enjoy the time off, and that's why it's there.
Too many parties, right? Too many fiestas.
That's right. But everybody getting back on track here is 2017. Sees its first soccer, Budweiser Soccer League action, Division One.
Mendiola's got some nice footwork there. Oh, Ashton
Serber, close opportunity, but loses it. Shielding off Pangolinan, and now Serber with some fancy footwork. It's around Tevin Pangolinan, sends it into the middle.
Oh,
and down went Ian Mariano. Right in front of the ball is, not sure what happened there, but he seemed to be alone and I think just got tripped up there on the
carpet. I'm going to say he did it on purpose. Just fake everybody out.
Ken Karosic now.
Right back to him. Oh, go Ken, go.
He saved that. Trying to save it from inbounds and does.
Now it's out. I don't know why he stopped on that. He had it. I think he thought he might have been offsides. I'm not too sure.
Waiting for the whistle that never came.
I thought that went off the Rovers player for a corner, but I guess not.
Napa Rovers now, they will sub in. Jason Cunliffe will let the time tick away, smartly so, and take his time taking the goal kick. Kind of
looks like
meanders back to the...
Yeah.
Leisurely walks back to the line.
Just strolls around back there. Ian Mariano took a sub. Wonder if that fall might have done something. Tweaked something or twisted something maybe.
And Evan Sandilands now hearing it from Jason Cunliffe.
Yeah.
Who's telling him to turn. And right to do so as he found some room when he did.
It's deep down in that corner for Shipyard over that throw-in. Those are some of the most dangerous spots for those throw-ins.
Easy to lose possession there. And
extremely
when
easy.
When you do, they're in perfect real estate just to cross it right to the middle of the box. Chris Santos taking a spill, landing on his back, getting right back up. Marcus Lopez being smothered by Karosic, and now the defense hearing it from Chris Santos as he makes his presence known with some speed, and Jason Cunliffe left all alone. Mark Chargaloff coming up.
Going deep, though.
Cunliffe sends it well downfield, and Jonah Romero there to pick up the rebound. And Romero with the hard strike and in the way. Was Landstrom looking for Guam Shipyard.
That was a good strike, too. Landstrom wasn't there. That might have been in that corner.
Oh!
Oh.
And a hard collision there. That was a hard hit. Chris Santos. And went airborne. But over there to check on him.
I'm very surprised there's not a card, though. Even a yellow card for that. He hit him very hard.
Time ticking away, and surely the ref will stop time for all the players that have gone down here in this second half.
It was Eddie Lorenzo that went down. It's never easy to take a shot from Debo like that.
Shot on goal, oh hard, low, and that's looked to be Marcus Lopez finding one more for good measure here in the 40th minute, or excuse me, in the 80th minute.
Nice, low, hard shot.
So that's that 85th minute.
Evans couldn't see much on that. All those defenders and the rest of the Rovers players up there. Not much he can do when you can't see it. There's a replay on that. Ashton sending it right back to him. Nicely set up.
And Sean Evans' vision just skewed by everybody that was in front of him.
You get to see him stand there and just watch it go by. He had no idea where it was going.
Jason Cundler. Got to be happy with his squad this evening. He's been giving all the directives from the back defensive line. And it's paid off 5-1. Rovers lead and Guam Shipyard just about 4 minutes away in regulation.
And Rovers has gone from the very first whistle.
They've been suffering after their first loss.
Jason come over for that throw in. Try to kill a couple more seconds. It's good pressure by Mark.
Rover's really just able to smother the offense back here defensively, and they'll send it back to David Drews. David Drews boots it out. Minchoy, though, within range, he's threatening. And almost a near collision there. Rover's now working it around. Jonah Romero over to Marcus Lopez. Lopez. So Jason Cunliffe back to Lopez. Lopez sends it up to Romero. Romero works his way around the ref, around the circles at midfield, chipped up. And now the Rovers just trying to settle things down, take their time. That's Ashton Serber being shadowed by Gadia. And Gadia back in the game. Romero over to the middle. Hard strike on goal.
Just wide,
just
though.
Too far and too wide is... Would have been an easy save had it reached Sean Evans directly, but Evans just watches it roll on out. He lines up for the goal kick, well past midfield. Chris Santos there to accept it, and the Rovers get possession. Just not really a smart giveaway of possession there, you know? I mean, though the time is winding down, you think that maybe they would roll it out and kind of work their way up the field, but four goals to one.
They're just trying to get that ball up high enough where they can get an opportunity to score. Mm-hmm. But the problem is they're not getting it to their players very well.
The defense just really able to predict everything that Shipyard's going to do for the Rovers.
Huh.
Free kick.
I don't think Landstrom appreciated that call very much. It was against him. Didn't look too terribly bad, though.
It's a close-range free kick, and they'll have to put up the wall.
You wonder from this range, does Jason take that shot and put it on frame, or does he try to pass it off? shot.
Jason looking for the shot. And
right into that wall, though.
Couldn't get it high enough. Crosses it over anyway. Sean Evans comes out, and good save. Ashton Serber shrieking to the box. He had Jonah Romero right atop of him.
Mark Chargaloff unable to control it, and kicks it out. Just not sure how much more time the referee's going to add on to this, winding down to the 90th minute now. Maybe a minute or two?
Maybe a minute or two. There were a couple players who came up kind of slow throughout the second half. I counted three, and no serious injuries, so not...
Which you're always thankful for.
Right. So not knowing what the referee will call here, he'll add it all up, or if he'll just say the game's over, and that's that. 5-1.
That's that.
And that's that. Budweiser Soccer League Division I, the Guam Shipyard suffered their first loss of the season. Napa Rovers 5-1. Hand the Guam Shipyard, top-ranked team, their first L of the year, just right after the holiday break and the New Year break. Not a good way for the Shipyard to start off the year, but Rovers look good. They look dominant, and if they can continue that, you got to think that they're going to be right there in the thick of it at the end. Here coming in the spring, but we're still a long way off from that. Red Dragon Sports, Guam Football Association, Taco Bell Live Mas, 76 Circle K, myself along with Shippy saying good night.